Welcome to episode 73 of Diecast TV Channel.
In this episode, Cobra reports on the first D cases in store. I have a curious observation on the Lincoln Continental short card. Eagle has some more supermarket dump bin finds, including the latest wave of Matchbox cars. And lastly, I'm back for a look at our first free DCTV Customs.
As I mentioned at the end of episode 72, Hot Wheels D-Case cars have shown up this week at stores in our area. Farmers department stores have a sprinkling of them, while our main source of Hot Wheels, the warehouse, now appears to have a good supply of them. Our first sighting of D-Case cars occurred after school when we walked into our local warehouse and saw the top of their dump bin was heaped with new cars. The green Volkswagen Cool Combi was the first clue. After digging around and finding three mainline versions of the orange 71 El Camino, we ended up taking the following bounty of cars to the checkout. One Renan rig. It's the first of this casting that I've ever picked up. One Mad Manga. It's a pretty wild paint scheme. One BMW 2002. A new blue variation. Three Classic Series Batmobile. Another Batman item for the collection. Three Flintstones Flintmobiles. Yabba dabba doo! Three Fast Fish. The latest treasure hunt. Oh yeah. And as luck would have it, one 71 El Camino Super Treasure Hunt. So that's almost all the cars we had on our list from the D-Case ticked off in one big hit. Pretty awesome. At another branch of the warehouse we visited a couple of days later, we did see more D-Cases up top, but another collector must have already got to them as the boxes had already been opened and the flaps were folded shut. Here's Falcon now with an acute observation.
When we were out at the supermarket looking at the pegs, I noticed that the car name on the 64 Lincoln Continental card features both upper and lowercase lettering. Normally the letter on the short card and long cards is completely uppercase, like on the classic Nomad beside it. The long card 64 Lincoln Continental is all uppercase. Curious, huh?
Last week, I reported on our Countdown Supermarket hexagonal dump bin finds and their fantastic 2 for $5 Hot Wheels and Matchbox special. Well, this week we found one branch had replenished their Hot Wheels dump bin stock and also added the latest wave of Matchbox to the mix. We had a bit of luck with the Hot Wheels finding these two guys buried amongst the piles. And here's what we brought home that night from the latest Matchbox wave. One MBX Construction Utility Tanker. Three MBX Adventure City 75 Chevy Vans with Wi-Fi repair tempos. And three MBX Adventure City Cadillac CTS wagons. These are actually going to be wheel donors for upcoming customs. Speaking of customs, here's Falcon with our first batch of DCTV customs.
That's right, the team of three at DCTV are trying our hand at customs. And we have the first pictures of them here for you today. Our first custom was an A-Team van with wheels donated by a Matchbox Ford Shelby GT500 convertible. Cobra used a special tool, a cordless Dremel stylus with a grinding bit in the collet, to cleanly remove the rivet heads until only the post was visible. From there he gently levered the base off with a small minus screwdriver, swapped the wheels, and then pressed the base back on. The snug fit means that, for the time being, we haven't had to use any glue, screws or new rivets to refasten the base. This was a straight swap without any issues and I really liked the result. The second was Cobra's Toyota A86 Corolla that received wheels from a Matchbox Porsche 911 Turbo. While the end result was a success, Cobra realized midway through that the axle links on the donor wheels was slightly shorter than required, so we had to do some extra chassis mods to fit the new mag wheels. Here's how it looked when complete. And our third custom was a Land Rover Discovery that received some large mag wheels from a Matchbox Fisker Karma Eva. This one rolls extremely smoothly and looks like it came straight out of the packet. We've got red Nissan Skyline GTR R34s and more Matchbox wheel donors on standby for the next batch. So stay tuned for more DCTV Customs.
That's it for episode 73 of DCTV Channel. Thank you to all of our channel viewers and subscribers for watching. We really enjoyed doing these customs. If you like them, feel free to leave us a comment. Have a great week, everyone. All the best from the team of three at DCTV.